We're going to look at metabolic pathways. So we're going to get a little geeky on it, just a little, I promise. So metabolic pathways. So the pathways are just your body's metabolic engines. They're the things that drive or fuel the activities that we may be doing. And we've got three. I'm just going to graph it up here, guys, for you, a graphical representation of it. So we've got the phosphagen or the phosphocreatine pathway. And that one lasts for about 10 seconds. Phosphagen. Good. And that fuels activities that require 100% of your power output. And what drives that is ADP. So ADP, adenosine triphosphate, is the energy molecule that's used to, that these different pathways make to make that activity happen. So in a 10 seconds, you think of something high powered. Somebody give me an example. Something that like, takes 10 seconds or less. What you got, Dom? 100-meter sprint. Yeah, think about Usain Bolt. He's got the world record in the 100-meter sprint. Anybody know what it is? 9.58, yeah. That's pretty fast. You're like, whoa. So that's underneath that 10 seconds. So all of the energy that he's using in that particular activity comes from that particular pathway. So our second pathway is the glycolytic or lactate pathway. Glycolytic, and that's responsible for 70% or derives 70% of its energy from for activities that go for no longer than 2 minutes, derive their energy from that pathway. So think about a 800-meter run. That's perfect, Wayne. Yeah, like an 800-meter run run by somebody who's maybe world-class or really good at it, like college level, mid, I'm not sure what you would call that team, but they're really good at the 800 meter. Not like my grandma's 800 meter. She'd be more aerobic, but we'll talk about that. But somebody's good. So 800 meter is perfect there. Then we have our last, our oxidative or aerobic pathway. And that we derive 40%. So our oxidative aerobic pathway, that's the one where it's low intensity, something you can go on and on with. Think over like a mile run if we're thinking about track. And that Wayne brings up the 800 meter, that's the best analogy I can think of for how to describe these three different pathways. The other important thing is you see how they all overlap? So the three engines are all running at the same time, but one is dominant depending on the activity. That makes sense? So Usain, when he's running that 100 meter sprint, glycolytic and oxidative, they just down here, waiting. I might need it, be needed, but I'm not. So I use it all there. Then in our 800, because of the distance and the amount of power that I need to run that 800, that's where I'm deriving most of my energy from. But the others are still kind of like right there. That makes sense to everybody? So we saw with the first model, we were looking for a balance of those adaptations. So here, we want to see a balance of the three different energy systems. So he or she, or metabolic pathways. So he or she is fittest, that's best balanced across those three metabolic pathways. So that means if I had a race, we're going to use Wayne's example of the 800 meter. I have three different events, three different athletes that are great at their event or specialists. So I've got the 100 meter. So let me do it in the colors. At the 100 meter sprint, I got the 800, and let's do race walk. How about a 5K? 5K, yeah, 5K. All right, those are my three different events. Who's going to win the 100 meter of those three? The 100 meter, yeah, all day and twice on Sunday, right? My husband says I'm cheesy, so you guys can laugh. I'm just going to get that out the way. So that's just how I am. Then we got the 800 meter. Who's going to win that one? The 800 meter, okay. And then the 5K? The 5K. But now who's going to come in second? So in the 100 meter, who's coming in second? Wayne's answering all the questions. Y'all agree with Wayne? 800 going to come in second on the 100 meter run. Yeah? Okay, then we get to the 5K. Who's going to come in second? The 800 meter. So who's best balanced across all of the three? The 800 meter. Yeah. So our 100 and our 5K, they kind of have to be specialists in those areas to go long and far out here or to be super fast and powerful here. But in the middle, I can touch both sides. So remember, you don't have to come in necessarily first. We're going to talk about that. You just need to not be last. You feel me? All right. So here we're looking for a balance of bioenergetics. And that's just the study of the transformation of energy in the body. That's a fancy way of saying that. Just want to be able to do stuff that's short and fast, moderate and not as fast, and then low and a little bit slower in terms of intensity.